Barnabas by Charles Dickens. Audiobook 22x48. If Lord George Gordon had appeared in the eyes of Mr. Willett, overnight, a nobleman of somewhat quaint and odd exterior, the impression was confirmed this morning, and increased a hundredfold. Sitting bolt upright upon his bony steed, with his long, straight hair, dangling about his face and fluttering in the wind, his limbs page 506/1.119 all angular and rigid, his elbows stuck out on either side ungracefully, and his whole frame jogged and shaken at every motion of his horse's feet, a more grotesque or more ungainly figure can hardly be conceived. In lieu of whip, he carried in his hand a great gold-headed cane, as large as any footman carries in these days, and his various modes of holding this unwieldy weapon now upright before his face like the saber of a horse soldier, now over his shoulder like a musket, now between his finger and thumb, but always in some uncouth and awkward fashion contributed in no small degree to the absurdity of his appearance. Stiff, lank, and solemn, dressed in an unusual manner, and ostentatiously exhibiting whether by design or accident all his peculiarities of carriage, gesture, and conduct, all the qualities, natural and artificial, in which he differed from other men, he might have moved the sternest looker on to laughter, and fully provoked the smiles and whispered jests which greeted his departure from the Maypole Inn. Quite unconscious, however, of the effect he produced, he trotted on beside his secretary, talking to himself nearly all the way, until they came within a mile or two of London, when now and then some passenger went by who knew him by sight, and pointed him out to someone else, and perhaps stood looking after him, or cried in jest or earnest as it might be, "Hurrah Geordie! No popery!" At which he would gravely pull off his hat, and bow. When they reached the town and rode along the streets, these notices became more frequent, some laughed, some hissed, some turned their heads page 507/1.119 and smiled, some wondered who he was, some ran along the pavement by his side and cheered. When this happened in a crush of carts and chairs and coaches, he would make a dead stop, and pulling off his hat, cry, "Gentlemen, no popery," to which the gentlemen would respond with lusty voices, and with 3x3, and then, on he would go again with a score or so of the raggedest, following at his horse's heels, and shouting till their throats were parched. The old ladies too, there were a great many old ladies in the streets,